In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate Holy Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do,
through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoice now in the restored glory of our adoption. We may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when we had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought the fulfillment, what you had announced beforehand, through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Lord, let your face shine on us.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
When I call, answer me, O my just God. You have relieved me when I am in distress. Have pity on me and hear my prayer.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Now that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one, the Lord will hear me when I call upon him.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we may know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, "I know him," but do not keep his commandments, are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand. Lord Jesus, open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn while you speak to us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place all the way, and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see. Because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning to all of you. The Gospel we just heard, especially the last words, Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the witnesses of these things." This morning, we may take a few minutes to reflect on these words. You are the witnesses of these things. Witnesses, this word witnesses including two meaning, to see something, to testify something. So the real meaning of witness is for us, for his disciples, to testify what they saw, to testify what they have experienced, and to witness what they believe. So that is what Jesus said to his disciples, to be the witnesses of the risen Lord. So what kind of things here it says, you are the witnesses of these things. What are those things? Look at the disciples. They followed Jesus for 3 years. Till the beginning, from bottom of their heart, they believed that Jesus will be their king to save the whole Israel. After 3 years, but they couldn't believe, their king was arrested, then crucified on the cross. When those disciples saw these kind of things happen, they are so disappointed. They are so scared. Some of them, they run away. Even these two disciples we just heard, they have no hope. They said, what we are going to do now? We followed him for 3 years. We have hope on him, but now he died. We have nothing. That is why they go back to the countryside. But after crucifixion, after 3 days, Jesus resurrected and appeared to them. So the king or the God they believe was completely beyond their imagination, completely beyond their expectation. Because they stand in front of them is God, like resurrected from the dead. It's unbelievable. They cannot trust him. They cannot believe themselves. Even they cannot believe their eyes can see the Jesus who died that now standing in front of them. But in order to confirm Jesus is really from the dead, then Jesus said, "Do you have something to eat?" Then they gave him a piece of baked fish that Jesus ate. Then Jesus also showed his hands, his feet, and his side in order to confirm the man who is standing in front of them is really Jesus Christ. So when the disciples saw him, they are so happy, joyful, that they believed that is the risen Lord. That is why Jesus said, okay, you have experienced, you have followed me so long. Right now, you know who I am. I am the dead from the dead and resurrected. You are these things, witnesses. So this morning, when we reflect on this gospel, Jesus will use the same words to tell each one of us, we are also the witnesses of the risen Lord. So how do we be the witnesses of the risen Lord? The real meaning of witness, to testify what we see, to witness what we experienced. Back to the Easter, or back to the Holy Week until now, 3 weeks has passed. What have we seen? What have we experienced about our faith? If we really enjoy it, then we will be the witnesses of the risen Lord. You may say, oh, Father, you know, I'm just an ordinary person, you know, I'm just a student, I'm just a worker. I have no any ability to be the witnesses of the risen Lord. What kind of thing should I preach? Where should I preach? And to whom should I preach? If you are still doubt about these questions or question about yourself, actually it's very simple. To be the witnesses of Jesus Christ for all of us, just be wherever we are, wherever we have been. If someone asks you, what did you do? You know, Easter, we have a few days holiday. I don't know how many days for you, 2 days. If your friends ask you, or even your employer asks you, What did you do for Easter Sunday, these 2 days? The chance comes for you to be a witness. You can explain what is the real meaning of the celebration of Easter. You can share the really when you celebrate the Easter you got from God's blessing, especially those happiness, joy, and peace. If you share with them, actually, that is the chance for you being a witness of Jesus Christ. Some of us, maybe we say, you know, Father, during the Easter time, my employees are so busy, they don't give me the holiday. I have to work with them. I have no chance to go to church. If you don't have this kind of chance, I'm very sure he will give you the extra. Maybe after 2 days is the holiday, they will give you another 2 days to let you go to celebrate Easter. But even like this, maybe you go to the church or maybe you go to share with your friends, whatever you have experienced, to share with your friends, share with your family, share with your employers. If we're doing like this way, actually, we are the witnesses of Jesus Christ. If you still don't have anything, actually, every Sunday, like today, you see, we come to here to attend Mass. After Mass, you will really enjoy your holiday today. No matter where we are, inside church or going to somewhere, you are so happy. You know why? Because you are waiting for this day. Maybe some of us, maybe we are so stressed to be with our employer, or finally today is my holiday, I will relax. Forget about those stressfulness. I will be happy, joyful today with my friends, with inside the church. When you enjoy with your day, when you go back to your place, don't put behind yourself. You know, sometimes if you have trouble with your friends or even your employer, almost finish your holiday. For example, you have to be at home at 9 o'clock. Before 9 o'clock, you feel like, 9 o'clock, so fast. How come it's so fast, the time? You don't want to go back. You know why? Because you don't want to face those kind of stressfulness. If you have this kind of feeling, actually, you have to go back. If you are later than 12 o'clock, maybe you have to go back to home. You have no choice. If you have no choice, why don't we take off another thing? Change our thoughts. Change our attitude. Anyway, I have no choice. I will breathe today the joyful happiness and peace into my place. No matter my employer give me a hard time, I'm happy. Then they will realize, that, how come you are different? Last Sunday, when I talked to you, give me a long face. How come today you are laughing? You smiling? It's a chance come. You know what? Today I share with my friends about the risen Lord. I got blessing from the risen Lord, joy, peace, and happiness. That is why I bring into the place to share with you. Then I will be the witnesses of Jesus Christ. So hopefully this morning, take this opportunity, ask myself, do I really want to be a witness of Jesus Christ? If we do, try this way. Enjoy your day. Bring your joy into the place wherever we have been. Then we will be the witnesses of Jesus Christ. God bless you. believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his Son, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God, the Father. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead.
The Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, in the breaking of the bread, Jesus Christ makes himself known to us as our life and our resurrection. He sends us to be witnesses to his name. Through him, we present our petitions and prayers to our loving God.
Lord, listen to your people.
Lord, listen to your people.
May your church be a beacon of light, helping people in darkness to come to know Jesus as the way, the truth, and the life. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May all leaders, by governing with fidelity, those entrusted to their care, build nation in peace, brotherhood, and respect for human dignity. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
Bless our labor that it may sustain our life on earth and enhance our human dignity. Ease our burden, make our faith strong, and inspire us to put our trust in you. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
Welcome into eternal life our deceased brothers and sisters, so that they may truly see the light of your countenance. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
Let us pray for the urgent concern of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
Gracious and loving God, you restored us to yourself through the resurrection of Christ, your Son. Hear the prayers of your people and strengthen us in giving witness to our Easter faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruits in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Is it right and just?
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceased to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angels sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took a bread, gave it thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave it thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and the resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Give you thanks that you have held us worthy to be your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis, our Bishop Cardinal Stephen Zhao, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, whom you have called them from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, especially pray for man's intentions. That with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Give us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Thank you. brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. A kind reminder, when you come up to receive the Holy Communion, please consume the Holy Communion in front of the altar and do not take it away or take it back to your seat. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by internal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for a while. Parish announcement. May 1st is the feast day of St. Joseph the Worker. We are praying the novena from March 3 for 9 consecutive Sundays at 12:30 p.m. All are welcome. Second, Deacon Matias Young, who served in our parish, returned to our Heavenly Father on April 3, 2024. The vigil service and funeral mass will be take place at our church on April 16, Tuesday, at 8 p.m. and April 17, Wednesday, at 10:30 a.m. Please refer to the details to be announced by the Diocesan Liturgy Commission. And lastly, confession is available at the back of the church at 11 a.m. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.